so grateful. Let me offer a plug right here. If you are interested in becoming an usher, please see Sister May Troy Murray yesterday. All right. As we continue to grow, we got to do that in all areas. All right. So if you're interested in becoming an usher, please see Sister May Troy yesterday. All right. It's just that important. Just that important. All right. 12 to 18, check. Can we please stand? 12 to 18? 12 to 18.
Well,
that That's called passive aggressive. I didn't come to the meeting, so I don't have to be accountable. Then I can keep saying they. Say no they, we. We speak French around here, we. But thanks be to God that the Lord is moving us to another level and helping us understand what ministry means and how it connects to our financial stewardship. So we build our finance ministry based on what our ministry needs are. See if I can make that plain. Most churches build their ministry needs based on their finances. That's an error. Because then we begin to look at money as our supply and not God as our supply. And the truth be told, if we're really doing ministry the way ministry is supposed to happen, we should never have enough on our own. Because if I got enough on my own, I'm not going to look to the hills from where my help comes from. Okay? Doesn't mean we treat God like Santa Claus or the Easter Bunny. We still have to be fiscally responsible. We're not going to throw God's money away just because God has blessed us. Capital something. We're going to seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness and all of these things, everything we need is going to be added unto us. Everything we need, whatever it is we need to finish developing them acres behind us. Yeah, God didn't give us that land to look at. Amen. Go out there and take pictures and see how much we got. Keep looking. As far as you can see it behind that, behind us.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
God didn't give us that to just look at. You've been so disappointed in Any of those things? So you don't go home tonight and start praying, Lord, I will prophesy.
availeth.
Keep us.
in praying for a miracle, you got to believe that deliverance is possible. If I don't believe God to deliver Sister Vicky, I don't need to pray for Sister Vicky. And if I don't pray for her and then turn around and talk about her, I don't need to. You know how much copay that was? 12 years. Issue of blood. And I imagine, because anything having to do with blood has to do with our life, the issue of blood, can you imagine? She must have been bent over, bruised in her spirit, anemic, very little life, tried vitamins, but they don't work, shunned by the community because she had an issue of blood. In the Bible days, when a woman experienced her cycle, she was supposed to be away from the public for the days of her cycle. This woman's cycle didn't stop. Issue of blood.
Yeah.
The woman touched Jesus. You don't need nobody's permission to pray. You don't need nobody's permission to have faith and believe. You don't have a title or position to do that. You don't have to preach no sermon to believe that God can do what the Word of God says that God can do. All you need is a measure of faith. Faith. That's all you need is a measure of faith. Then the woman now stand tall, saying, she ain't got to be bent over no more. Stand up! She was trying to get out of the way, but the Bible says, seeing that she could not go unnoticed, she came trembling and fell at his feet. And watch this, she wasn't ashamed. See, some people need stuff from the Lord. I'm gonna get inside. Somebody said talk about them. Some people need stuff from you, Lord, but they're scared. They don't wanna lay out. They're scared, they're gonna kiss the floor. They're scared. She wasn't ashamed to go for what she needed. When we get to that place of desperation, and we'll seek God at all costs, ain't no stopping us. Ain't no blocking us from what God has in store. Then he said to her, daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace. Before, it's all right for you to do church on Sunday, but you better live on Monday. Holy. Bible says, do not worry. Can't see the birds in the air, the lilies in the field. Don't you think he'll take care of you? But if you need a miracle, say you need a miracle. If you need a supernatural touch from God, say that's what you need. Stop from no God. You know the situation is beyond your control. You know ain't a thing else you can do about that situation.
In the name of Jesus.
tonight, I will be standing at the back if you need to be anointed tonight. We are going to allow God's power. We're going to allow God's power. And the oil is a sign of faith to match up with your faith. If you ain't got no faith, I can anoint you until you receive. And nothing will happen. But if you got faith, because of your faith connects with my faith, yeah, and the oil is just a symbol. Bob said that was one in my head before, and my cup runneth over. That's not a money cup. It's a cup of salvation, cup of deliverance, cup of joy, cup of peace. And when you've got those things working in your life, provision will come. God will send somebody to bless you with what you need. I know what I'm talking about tonight. My sisters, my brothers, the miracle of healing is a supernatural gift that can only come from God. Sister Wanda, when you are done with your prayer request, I want you to meet me in the back. Anytime you're anointing people, you need somebody praying for you. Amen. And I'll teach you a little more about that too. Hallelujah. Amen. Tonight is our opportunity to experience the joy of the Lord like never before. Brother Calvin, will you please bless us? And as I said, once you're done writing and take it to the table that corresponds with that prayer request, you say your prayer. You say your prayer. And as you return to your seat, continue to pray. There should be no talking. No talking. This is sacred time. God bless you. And whenever